Hello everybody, my name is Mattie and I'm back with another reaction video. Today we're going to be reacting to a new artist as suggested by you guys in the comments. Thank you for your suggestions, I always appreciate them. If you didn't know, this channel has been rebranded to a reaction video only channel. So if you're interested in some of the other videos or music content that I create, please check out my channel in the description below and subscribe to it there. Today we're going to be listening to Conan Gray for the very first time, right as of now. No idea who this is. And we're going to be reacting to a song called Heather. I always love seeing music from new singer-songwriter. I'm assuming that's what he is. Maybe he's a secret K-pop artist from all the K-pop fans that watch this channel. But I guess only time will tell. As we go through the song, I'll be pausing periodically and giving my thoughts as from the standpoint of a musician, from the standpoint of a music producer, and tell you about some of the things that are happening from a music theory perspective. Maybe some things that might fit together a better picture of what's happening musically. Here we go. Let's do it. Conan Gray, Heather. My first time reaction, bada bang. Right off the bat, I'm not getting K-pop vibes. It's more of an indie folk vibe, and I'm wondering if that vibe will stay the same throughout the whole song, or if it'll change. We have a nice acoustic guitar, some simple strumming, a little atmospheric pad synth in the background. Let's continue on. I like the vibe so far. Nice chord there, a little minor four chord.
I still remember 3rd of December, me in your sweater. You said it looked better on me than it did you. Only if you knew how much I liked you. But I watch your eyes as she walks by. What is...
That was a sweet harmony. I hope to hear more of those harmonies coming back in. The lead vocal and the background harmonies all slid up into the notes and it sounded nice. All right, continuing on. There it is.
Brighter than the blue sky.
That was such a sick
harmony. You mesmerized while I die.
Oh, it's just polyester, but you like her better? Okay, I didn't even hear him say that yet, but that's a great line. I can read it in the captions. Amazing. I wanted to stop and just compliment Conan Gray's voice. It is awesome. It's a really pleasant voice to listen to. He's not doing anything technically that difficult, but he doesn't have to, right? This is more of an indie folk acoustic type song, and I'm guessing that the rest of his songs are similar to this type vibe, and his voice fits that genre so well. You can feel the emotion in his singing, and that is such a powerful thing. The best songs, in my opinion, are the ones that elicit emotions, and the best way to elicit emotions is through the voice. It's the biggest thing that we latch onto as listeners, and his voice is absolutely killer for this song. Not to mention his vocal harmonies in the background, icing on the cake, really.
That's polyester, but you like her better. Wish I were Heather. Watch as she stands with her holding your hand. Put your arm round her shoulder. Now I'm getting colder, but how could I hate her? She's such an angel. But then again, kinda wish she were dead as she walks by.
Okay, here is something that I noticed about that last line. Conan didn't rhyme the last lyric of that verse, and he said, I wish she were dead, which did not rhyme with the previous line, as he was following that pattern, AABB, if you will. It seemed out of place, but that's a tool that songwriters can use to add emphasis to a line. Instead of rhyming every line, having one line specifically stick out, or something that is jarring because it doesn't rhyme, like, I wish she were dead, is potent. It makes it more recognizable for the person or the listener to stick out. That line is going to be more memorable and more meaningful because it doesn't rhyme. That makes sense. And so, well done. Well done. I like it.
What a sight for sore eyes, brighter than
All right. What a song. What a song. The chords of the song are not changing throughout the verse and throughout the bridge, throughout the chorus. They have been the same. They've been the same sort of acoustic guitar strumming type vibe the entire time. But what they've differentiated these parts with have been different elements. In the second verse, they added sort of a pad type sound, where in the first verse, it was just the acoustic guitar. And then in the chorus, they're adding a bass and they're adding some light drums to give it a more impactful feel. This isn't a highly energetic song, but it doesn't have to be. It's an intimate song. It's a song that means a lot, obviously, to Conan Gray. And like I said, the songs that can elicit emotions or that can make you feel what the writer was feeling as he was writing it are some of the most powerful songs, and this is what that reminds me of. It would fall into that category in my mind. Let's continue on and hear the ending. I'm guessing the chorus will come back again. Love the lyrics to the chorus, by the way.
Why would you ever kiss me? I'm not even half as pretty. You gave her your sweater. It's just polyester, but you like her better. Wish I were.
A million likes? Damn. Well, I'm sure you got more in this video, Conan. Okay, 115 million. I'm not even surprised, really. It was a fantastic song. Never have I ever heard of Conan Gray, but the power in his voice, the power in his lyrics, amazing. He wasn't breaking any musical ground with his composition or his arrangement or his chords, but the power in those lyrics and his voice combined, it was just... It created a soundscape. It created an emotion. It was touching. You could feel the heartbreak that Conan was going through when he was writing this song. And that's such a hard thing to do as a songwriter. And probably the thing as a songwriter that sets apart the mediocre songwriters, the really good songwriters, and the amazing songwriters. And this song was amazingly written, I have to say. Once again, blown away by the suggestions that you guys have given. Keep them coming. I love music. I love listening to it, and hearing people like this just is inspiring. I will absolutely be checking out some more of Conan Gray's stuff in the future. If you have a song suggestion for me, please leave it in the comments below. From Conan Gray, from any other band that you think I might like or might want to hear my opinions on. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time, thanks for watching.